We're going to start with a size 12 emerger hook and 70 near black thread. And tie it all the way down and deep into the bend of the hook. The next stuff we tie in, this fly fish food freezer cream. Flashy, it's a flash ice dubbing, but it looks white, but when it hit the water hits it, it'll turn more like a opaque to represent the shuck that the fly is stuck in. Next, we tie in a gold wire, fine gold wire, to represent a rib. You want to tie that wire in on top, and then you want to completely smooth out the body with your thread. I'm just going to use the black thread as a body and the wire as a rib. Alright, I am making this body smooth to wrap the wire through it. I wanted to get a point to tell you that this fly is, we call it many things. This is called a cripple, stillborn, stuck in the shuck. They come to the surface to merge and they never break. They either break through the surface film and too tired to go any further and die, or other reasons, but they die on the surface. And the trout will focus their attention on these because they won't fly away. And they know they could just have an easy meal. Okay, next we're gonna have a piece of that floating yarn. Comes by many names. But we're gonna take a really little bit of that, we're gonna tie that in next. Next, we're gonna grab a clump of deer hair, elk hair, depends on what color of wing you want. And then we're gonna pull, put in a deer hair stacker. I like to, not for emergers, I don't, because I like to like chaos of the wing because it's an emerger. So now I got a perfect looking wing yet. And then I grab it by the tips and pull all the webbing out. And I'm gonna tie that in. And I'll make the length of that wing the length of what the shank should be. Now we're going to cut that deer hair off really close, super close to the thread wraps, and we're going to leave that floatable yarn hang out the back just a little bit longer. Now it'll look like a trailing shuck that I caught in. Now for the grizzly hackle. I like grizzly on these because of this, the molding on it. So there you go. We're gonna tie this on. A lot of steps. Almost done. All right. Y'all know how to wrap hackle. Make sure you click like and subscribe to our channel. You don't miss any of these. This, you won't find this video, this fly on any other channel. This is my version of a cripple. Deadly, because it's proven in the on the water. So if you like fish, flies that catch fish, not just fishermen, subscribe. So you're gonna pull the wing back and that floaty yarn back, and you're gonna tie right in front of it, make it stand up, form a head, whip finish it, but don't go anywhere, we're not done yet. Alright, now the floating yarn sticking forward, or the front forward shuck, I'd like to trim that at about a quarter inch length, and then I go back to the back where the tail would be, or the trailing back shuck. I like to trim that about half of the body length. Tie this fly up, man. This thing's deadly. This is also as deadly as my New Zealand strike indicator. Tie these up. Come check us out tonight, or this Saturday, live stream at 9 o'clock. Keep your lines wet, out of the trees, and only give them fish a sore lip. You guys have a good night.